came to chemistry. I like the idea of mixing things together and seeing them like change color or fizzle or explode. But then I learned what it was about. Learning what is the structure of an atom, what are electrons, in what sense are they orbiting the nucleus of the atom. So from there I just kind of got pulled into science. I became interested in the HIV carbohydrate vaccine problem. Not all antibodies that people make against HIV are useless. We want a person who's been vaccinated to make these really good and useful antibodies, not the kind of useless antibodies that most people make. These good antibodies, they target certain surfaces on HIV. We want the carbohydrate cluster that is really a fantastic mimic of the HIV surface. We want the best of the best, and so we go through this selection process for many rounds. We select the best members of the population, we replicate them, select again and replicate. So what we've found is that if we do this selection process at physiological temperature, as opposed to doing it at room temperature, then the population of carbohydrate-containing molecules seems to evolve to give us some very good mimics of the HIV virus. We think that they are pretty interesting as possible HIV vaccine candidates. I would never in a million years thought that raising the temperature of our process was going to be the thing that works so well. Science is not about saying, I'm going to do XYZ, and then I accomplish XYZ. And if you're too dead set on specifically accomplishing XYZ, you're not necessarily going to discover all the things that are out there to discover.